This class is presented to you by Dr. Adam Cohen, teacher at the Turiya Ashram in India.
Samavriti Pranayama is a highly practical, yet fairly simple breathing technique we can use at any point during our day to bring ourselves into a state of balance and equilibrium. This practice is accomplished by equalizing the movement of the inhalation with the exhalation. Sometimes this is referred to as cyclical breathing. As if you were to draw a diagram resembling the breath, it would look like a circle. The length of the inhalation is exactly the same as the length of the exhalation, and the movement of the breath, the speed and tempo, is equalized throughout the breathing cycle. For this practice, you're going to be seated in an upright seated posture, which means you can either be seated upon the ground or in a chair. Begin by first just observing the natural and spontaneous inspiration and expiration. Become connected to as many features of the breath as your awareness allows, including the depth of your breath, the length of the breath, the location of your breath, and the volume of your breath. In regards to the location of your breath, are you breathing more in the abdomen or in the chest? For this practice, we want to use all of the lungs, which means that the breath should envelop both the abdomen and the chest. This is accomplished by the inclusion of the movement of the diaphragm as well as the expansion of the rib cage. Begin now to try to create this. Inhale, your belly is expanding because the diaphragm is descending, and your ribs are expanding as the lungs expand. And as you exhale, ribs release, diaphragm ascends, and abdomen relaxes. Now, what about the volume of your breath? How much air are you inspiring and expiring with the respiratory cycle? Let's try to increase this now, taking more full and complete inhalations and exhalations. Now the rhythm and tempo of your breath. Are there any pauses within your breath? Are you inhaling faster than you're exhaling? Try now to balance out the inhalation and the exhalation and connect the two in a stream-like manner so that there's no division, no apparent division between the inspiration and the expiration. Now, in addition to all the qualities that we've covered this far, let's add one more. Equalized length of inhalation and exhalation guided by a count. This is accomplished by counting in addition to chanting the mantra Om. The Om provides the proper length for the count. Demonstrate. So for the inhalation, it'll be Om 1, Om 2, Om 3, Om 4. And then the exhalation similar. Om 1, Om 2, Om 3, Om 4. Continue counting mentally. Inhaling, counting to 4. Exhaling, counting to 4. If you find that this is too short, then you can lengthen. But only increase the length within a zone that is comfortable and healthy. You know that you've gone outside of your natural zone when you start to feel fatigued, tired, or the urge to gasp for breath. So again, all the modifications we've discussed so far, with the addition of this breathing counting that is going to harmonize the length of the inhalation with the exhalation so that the breath is in total accord. Continue observing the breath with this modification. Hopefully, this modification does not create fatigue. If it does, then take rest. Really create the cyclical nature of the breath here. Equalized breathing. That is the full intention of this practice. The breath should feel so natural and so smooth that it's transforming the nature of your thoughts and the experience of your body. Now release any modifications of the breath and return to an unmodified, unaltered, natural breath. Observe the changes that have occurred because of the breathing practice. Closing the practice now by chanting the mantra Om 3 times. Namaste. You can find more free resources on yoga, including videos, audios, and articles on our website, studyofyoga.org. We believe that spiritual knowledge can change the world and bring forth a new path for humanity to become integrally connected to themselves and the world in which they live. Therefore, all materials we provide are available for free. However, if you would like to make a donation to help us expand our collection of resources as well as support our community projects in India, please contact us at info@studyofyoga.org. That's info@studyofyoga.org. Your contributions are nourishment for the lives of others who share a vision for a more peaceful and holistically unified future. Thank you for listening. May you be a light unto the world, so that the glory of truth and wisdom may shine in the hearts of all.